We meet again. So thank you for being with us for Alternative Cinema. I'd like to know why the theme of revolution to start with.
Yes, revolution. I mean, it's like it's 1968, it's 2018. In Germany, we even had 1918 with the first revolution after the First World War. So 1968 for us is like, it was so powerful, this movement, this will to change the world somehow. I mean, it was a worldwide movement, perhaps best compared to Arab Spring. But and in Germany, especially with all the fascist history and background and the young generation confronting their parents. So there was a lot of really movement going on, changing, wanting sexuality, you know. So we thought it's a good moment because at the moment as well, there's something happening in the world. So discourse is going on. It's no longer that everything stands still, but there is something. So we thought it's a very good movement, a very good moment to think what they did and what kind of energy led them. And so I created a program which is actually based on very personal positions, very subjective films. It's deconstructing stories. It's been working a lot with the formal aspects of filmmaking. It's really the material.
Torn apart and put together back
again. Put together again in a very beautiful way. So we never see people on the street demonstrating. I don't show the stereotyped images of what is 68, and then you see one image and you know. But it's a three-hour program of meeting people, basically. And they're very free, very radical positions. And you see this program and you think like, wow, what did they do? Where is this energy today? And you get inspired, I guess.
And what's the film that stands out in this?
Actually, there are, it's very difficult to say, but I think there are two films that stand out. One is made by famous German film director Ulla Stöckel, who just became 80 years now, and her film is Antigone, and she reduced it to 7 minutes and showing the how ridiculous it is to make war. And basically it's about the question what I have done, because Ulla Stöckel in 1966, of course she was, the movement already started, the energy was there, she had to confront her family who weren't able to talk about what happened to them during fascism, what did they do. So she wondered, she cannot put them on trial because she hadn't, you know, she wasn't in the same position, still wondering how would she have acted. So that's Antigone. What do you do if your brother is not allowed to be buried, you know, and your father says no? The second film is like, if this is the fictional part. So on the other hand, we have the experimental parts, and then it's Roh film by Wilhelm and Birgit Hein. They've been a couple in that time, and they've been working on structural structureller film, structural movies, you know, like, so what they were interested in was to say it's no longer about storytelling, because the stories that we've been told, they are, it's crap, you know, that doesn't work, we have to restart storytelling from scratch. So they took the movie and scratched the material, put together, shot from the video, as I had their first videos players, so they shot from television, put it into the film. It's really, it's a restart about what is an image and how you come from an image to something else. So it's really these two positions. And actually it was in this sense in the 60s, it was expanded cinema, which started out in New York City and in Vienna and them in Cologne. So it was, and they met in Hamburg for a filmmakers meeting, and they funded the first film cooperative in Germany. They had role models in New York City and London, like Jonas Mekas, famous Jonas Mekas. Yeah, but he funded this film Mekas Cooperative, and they did it in Hamburg as well, because they thought, yes, we have to work together to throw our ideas of a different cinema into the world, and that's what they did.
Mikey, you are in charge of the very difficult task of choosing from thousands of films that get submitted to you, and each year you have a central theme or like a line of thought that you follow to choose your films. We'd like to know how the process functions. How do you start and how does it end when you choose your films?
When we start like from scratch every year again, which is beautiful because you always think this year is so great, how can something else come up again? And then it just comes, because creativity is not been stopped. You cannot stop creativity. You cannot stop people to think. So that's wonderful. So it's about us to understand where are tones, what's interesting, what's happening, because you know when it's something in the air.
So you are guided by the flow.
Yeah, I'm guided by the flow. And the flow, for example, this year, this stands out, I think, through all the sections in the festival. It's like people take over, they empower themselves, they go for it. You know, they are interested in the other, they are interested in understanding who they are, and they are no longer a victim.
But also the sexuality is very present in the Arab-Israeli conflict in one of the films shown in the shorts section. Tell us about it.
Yeah, there is a film from an Israeli artist, Ines, and her film is called The Men Behind the Wall. And it's about herself because, she thinks, she sees Tinder and she says, okay, Tinder is the one that goes beyond walls because walls are not interesting for Tinder. Tinder just matches. So she gets a lot of matches with Palestinian men. And as an Israeli lady, she's an Israeli person, she's not allowed to cross the border into the West Bank. But still she goes. So she drives to Ramallah. And so the film has many, many layers, but it's just so interesting because she meets this man and she's just like, she likes hard sex. They speak about it. It's about images of and fantasies about Arab men and fantasies about Israeli women, you know. It's about opening up with your expectations, your fears, your desire. And it's, I think in this sense, very contemporary that we don't have to fear. We just have to talk to each other. She talks about what she did and what she wanted and the way she wants to go further and meeting people. And that's, I think, what it's all about in the end. I mean, we have to meet each other. As you said, we have to confront us with the questions of the other. If we don't meet the other, how, you know, because the conflict been there, but now that we know. So how can we change conflict? If we don't have sex with one another and meeting and make love, hey, I don't see a change. So basically, it's a way to change the world.
Maike Miahuni, thank you very much.
Thank you very much for being here again.